myself. I am Shini, new teacher for chemistry. Due to this corona, we couldn't be able to meet. So, let us begin the class. In your textbook, the first 5 chapters are from chemistry. Maybe you have seen, you went through the textbook, right? First one is chemical reactions and equations. Second one, acid, bases and salt. Third one, metals and non-metals. Fourth one, carbon and its compounds. And the fifth is periodic classification of elements. So, maybe March your teacher have taken some portion for you. Anyway, we can begin from the starting itself. First chapter is chemical reactions and equations. Before starting the lesson, let us go through some daily life experiences. For example, maybe you experience when you are having the habit of using bicycle, right? So, if a cycle without using, if you keep oil for long days, what will happen? What you can see on the surface of the cycle, you can see a brown coating. Chemically it is known as rust. That is because of the oxidation of iron, we can see a brown coating on the surface of the cycle, that is known as rust. And this rust or this brown coating can be converted into the iron. No, it is not possible. Similarly, if we keep milk for long hours without keeping in the refrigerator, if you keep the milk outside at the room temperature for long hours, for 2-3 hours, what will happen? It will change into curd. Yes? And this curd cannot be converted into milk again. And another one, another example, that is when we eat, when food is cooked, the cooked food can't be converted into its initial stage. For another example, if we burn a piece of paper will change into ash, and the ashes cannot be converted into paper again. Yes? So in all these, the newly formed substance cannot be converted into its initial form. Such changes in chemistry are known as chemical changes. So what are chemical changes? Chemical changes are changes in which a substance combines with another substance to form a new substance, and the newly formed substance cannot be converted into its initial form, are known as chemical changes. And chemical changes are also known as chemical reactions. So our chapter is chemical reactions and equations. Chemical changes are also known as chemical reactions. Chemical reactions and equations. So we are going to see in more detail about chemical reactions. If you want to know the definition, then it is written right here. What are chemical changes? Changes in which a substance combines with another substance. Iron oxide, this formula is what we will study later. like in lower grades, maybe you have already learned, yes? So such changes are known as chemical changes. And whenever we say about chemical changes, let us we have to go through physical changes also. So in one sentence we can say, what is physical changes? What is physical change? We set the example of burning of paper. Let us consider cutting of paper. If we cut a piece of paper, we get what about the change? We are changing only the size and shape of the paper. Paper is not changing into any other substance, right? So we can say physical change is a temporary change. Only the size and shape of the substance is changing. The substance is not changing into any other substance. That is why physical change is a temporary change. Whereas chemical change is a permanent change. Now let us see more examples of chemical changes. And I said chemical changes are also known as chemical reactions. The first example, in the form of activities, it is given in your textbook. The first activity given in your textbook is burning of magnesium rubber. Burning of magnesium rubber. Magnesium, symbol of magnesium is Mg. Okay. So magnesium is a gray colored metal. When we burn magnesium rubber, we can see a white dazzling clay. White dazzling clay, and it changes into a white powder. Magnesium burns with a white dazzling clay and changes into a white powder. Changes into a white powder. This white powder is magnesium oxide. And this magnesium oxide, that white powder, it can't convert into magnesium back. So it is an example for a